March is Brain Prevention Injury Month. See, we don't want people to get hit in the head. Dave, by the way, the guy operating this camera, you've had your head hit before, haven't you? Yeah, doesn't feel good. And my friend Trey right here, he is 5 years old. He's going to demonstrate in just a moment the proper way to wear a helmet. Because, Trey, you've never hit your head, have you? No, and you never want to. No. Your grandma's here, and she's got a helmet to put on your head. Are you ready? Okay. He's going to be our young mannequin. And that's Sharon Rowell right over there. Sharon is a registered nurse, and she's at Children's Hospital. You're also a community education instructor.
Yes.
Come on over here. And this little guy right here said it's cool to wear a helmet.
It
we
is
agree.
Cool. We do. We do. It is cool to wear a helmet, and it's safer to wear a helmet.
Because in the warmer weather, this is when you start seeing a lot of kids showing up with their parents, and they're hurting.
Exactly. You're right.
Yeah.
A helmet's going to protect your head.
What did we do before helmets? Can you think back on those days? Remember
I remember days not wearing helmets, and we were just taking big risks.
Yeah. Well, let's show everybody the proper way.
Okay.
And this helmet almost looks like it's too big for his head.
Well, actually, this is the part that's important, the part that's inside.
The inside,
And that's what's difficult about helmets. You can't just get one off the shelf and put it on your head and think that fits.
Let's show Dave right here, because he's had some problems in the past if he wanted to wear one. You've got different adjustments right here.
Exactly.
And what does that do exactly? That brings it in?
It's a dial. You can turn it, and it's going to fit around the back of the head. And then a lot of people think that these pads are actually for comfort. They make it softer, and that's not true. They're actually to fit the helmet around your head.
Okay.
So these come in different widths. There'll be some that'll be thicker than this and some that'll be thinner. So a lot of times we play around with these, seeing which helps the helmet fit the best.
All right, Trey says, Grandma, I'm ready.
So with this one, we know that we were trying these foam pieces in here, and I put it on his head. I want it to fit on there securely.
Okay.
I don't want it to feel too big. I also don't want it too tight, because it's going to ride up here.
Mm-hmm.
So we want it right down here on the top of his head so that it touches his head all the way around, and it's securely touching his head
all the
way around.
Okay, that's good.
And then the other thing is, we don't want him wearing it back like this, because that's not going to protect very much either. We want it right down here on the top of his head, and usually like just a finger above the eyebrow.
And if they didn't have the helmet on, got hit in the front of the head, it also affects the back of the
head
as well.
Yes, exactly. And a lot of times we tell them this line right here, you want that parallel to the ground, and see if it's like this. That's not parallel to the ground. So putting it right like that, so there's just, you know, a little bit of room. And then these straps, the back strap holds down the back of the helmet, so it's on. But the front holds down the front. So that way, when these two are holding it down, they're holding it down on your head. If this one's too long, it's going to slip to the back.
Gotcha.
This one's going to slip to the front. So we adjust these so that they actually make a Y on either side of his ear, with the point of this Y coming right below his earlobe right here.
Mm-hmm.
So it makes a Y here, and then this piece right here. And then when we go to fasten it, we want to make sure that he only has one finger between his chin.
Right, that's the key right there, ladies and gentlemen.
Very much so, yes.
Yeah. He's laughing. Is that
because
tickle?
We don't, when a crash, when if something crashed, if he fell and this crashed and pushed up, we don't want the strap coming above his chin and off. That's not going to do him any good at all. He has the helmet on, but now it's laying on the ground next to him.
Sharing some good advice. And also, we bring this up because with the warmer weather, the kids are getting back out on the bike. Their heads grow. It's like a shoe size.
Exactly.
Every year. And you have to readjust it.
Every year.
Every year.
Yeah.
Thanks, Sharon.
Thank you very much.
Trey, way to go. Are you on a two-wheeler yet? Or you have a three-wheeler? He still has a training wheel.
Yeah, I still have the training wheels on.
All right. Well, good for you, man.
But
thanks
for
helping
out. Every time he's
got to have the helmet on. Dave, wear your helmet as well. I think he learned something, Randy.